Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to station number 19, where we are talking the last of our joints. So the joints of the distal leg, as well as the ankle or talocrural joint. So we are looking at the distal end of the tibia, and you can see a bit of the fibula over here. And this is the talus projecting superiorly. So you are looking right here at where we have the articulation to form the talocrural or ankle joint. So I'm going to kind of draw an arrow at which where the cavity for your ankle joint would be. Now, you do have some distal joints associated with how the tibia and the fibula actually articulate with one another. You can see a bit of the interosseous membrane here, which would extend kind of the whole length of the shafts or the bodies of the tibia and the fibula. So we're just seeing the distalmost portions of it here. And then right here, basically right around where this yellow ligament is going to be where the distal portions of the tibia and the fibula are going to articulate, and that is going to form the distal tibiofibular joint. And both the interosseous membrane and this distal tibiofibular joint are examples of syndesmoses. And if you recall, what type of joint is that? It's a fibrous joint. So these are not synovial joints right here. Whereas this ankle or talocrural joint is a synovial joint. It's a hinge joint. This ligament, just in case you were wondering, but you don't have to identify it, is going to be the anterior tibiofibular ligament. So it has tibio and fibula. So it has both tibia and fibula in it. So it's indicating that has to do with one of the tibiofibular joints. Whereas any of these other ones typically will have, it will have its tarsal bone and another more proximal bone attachment for the ligaments associated with the ankle joint. Okay, so one of those ligaments you can see here is part of the lateral ligament complex, and it will be on the lateral side. This is the medial malleolus of the tibia. This is that lateral malleolus of the fibula. And you can see one of the lateral ligaments here, and we'll see another view of it in another image. But this is that ATFL or anterior talofibular ligament. Again, you don't have to identify that specifically, but just in case you were wondering the specific name of that. Now, looking at a medial view of the ankle joint region, I know I'm looking at a medial view because here's the first digit or the great toe, which is always medial. And you can see a complex of ligaments here shaded in light blue, which are referred to as either the medial ligaments or the deltoid ligaments. And these are very robust. They're very protective of this region. And you can see that there's separate ligaments in this region, but they're all going to kind of coalesce and have an intermingling of their fibers on the medial malleolus here. So that serves to be a bit more protective than what you have on the lateral side of the joint. And this here is still going to be that distal tibiofibular joint right here. So this actually is going to be associated with that joint. But these two ligaments right here, and there'll be another one, there'll be a third one that you can't quite see in this image, are going to be parts of the lateral ligaments of the ankle joint, and they both have an attachment to the lateral malleolus, which you can see here, but their fibers don't intermingle quite as much as what you have on the medial side or the deltoid side, so not quite as protective as what you have on the medial portion of the ankle joint. All right. Excellent. So thank you for your time and attention here. We have finished our joints for the MSK portion, and now we are going to move into the muscles of the lower limb. So I'll see you at the next station.